get it. But I wanted to tell a story about family and the struggle to keep it together. And every time it's Christmas, time has gone by. Okay, every time it's Christmas, time has gone by. So kind of think of that as the story's moving forward. Okay, thank you. We're gonna start.
I lie in my bed, your name's running through my head. All I can think of is you and all that you do. The way you look at me, I feel as if I'm in a dream. The blue sky reminds me of your eyes, which give me butterflies. You have brightened my smile with that beautiful smile. No longer are my days a trial. Your touch is like heaven upon my young skin. If only you knew that what I say is true, I would do anything just to be with you. Hand to hand, palm to palm, just hold me in your arms. I love you with all my heart, till the very day it falls apart. I may be young, but my heart is strong. I know what love is, it's my name and his. You make all the problems float away, no matter how was my day. I love our heart-to-heart chats, when our beats connect, and when my head starts to fade back from when the blue sky turns sacred black.
If I let myself fall, will you catch me in your arms? Will you be there to soften my fall? Sometimes you have to fall to know if there's anyone there to catch you, to know if anyone cares. I let myself fall because I trust you. I believe in you. I know you will always be there for me. You give me hope, bring me comfort, reach out to me in the darkness and show me the light. You are my guiding light that leads me from the darkness, saving me from the bottomless abyss of my soul. Falling, falling, into never-ending night, endlessly lost in nothingness until you appear, waiting for me, waiting to catch me in your arms and hold me so I never fall again.
I always knew that love would come find me someday, but never did I know that it would be you who was headed my way. You caught me off guard and took me by surprise. But you simply captivated me, the same way you do when I look into your eyes. It's true that every good and perfect gift is from above. You were presented to me as a beautifully packaged gift full of humor, talent, grace, beauty, and love. It isn't finding the perfect person, but learning to see an imperfect person perfectly. We all have our flaws, but when I view you through my eyes, perfection is all I see.
Dad, why did you do it? Didn't you ever feel any guilt leaving a woman with four little kids and one on the way just because Miss Perfect for you comes along? You know your son David? He's never even met you. He's never met his own father. You know, I used to think you were like this perfect, handsome, loving guy who only made one mistake in his whole entire life, and that was when you left us. I thought that if you came back, you would realize how much you had messed up. I wrote you like 20 letters, asking you to come back, but then I found out Mom never sent them. When I was in elementary school, there was this father-daughter dance every year. Mackenzie and her dad would always drag me there so I wouldn't feel left out or whatever. After everybody ate, they'd all go into this big fancy room where they could dance. I'd pretend to still be eating, so they'd leave me alone. Everyone would leave the room, and the DJ would turn on this really slow music, and all the girls would dance with their dads. I knew better than to go in there, because by this point, I'd be crying. I'd sit in the booth for the first song, but after that, I'd get up and, this sounds so stupid now, I'd pretend to dance with you. Song after song after song, and it felt so good inside to think that you were there and that you loved me. But I don't need that anymore, Dad. I started going to church with Jamie, and you know what I found out? I found out God loves me way more than you ever will, and he won't ever walk out on me, and that is way more than enough.
I'm 12. Yes, I'm only 12. I don't know everything you do. But I need you to listen to me, because I think I know something here. I know when you yell at Mom, it's usually because you think you're right and she's wrong. But if Mom's crying because you're yelling about how wrong she is, then I think you're even more wrong. I'm only 12, as you'd like to remind me. You know more stuff, but I know there must be a better way to make your point than to stick Mom with it until she cries. Maybe you could soften your point.
Now wait just a minute. May I remind you that you walked out on us, Dad? You walked out on us, not the other way around. How can I be abandoning you when you left first? And now you show up, and just because some time has passed, you think everything is fine and dandy. You think you can just waltz back into my life like nothing happened? And you expect me to meet your new wife and kid on top of that? I always thought you were insane. But now, I'm sure of it. I don't know what kind of fantasy takes place in your mind, but this is the real world, Dad. I have no desire to meet your new wife. I have no desire to be big sister to your new kid. I have no desire to see you or know you anymore. You don't even realize how much hurt you've caused Mom and me. That's what really gets me. You have no idea the damage you do to people. Maybe someday, I'll change my mind, but I doubt it. For now, I don't care if I ever see you again. As far as I'm concerned, I have no father.
Daddy? Daddy, is that you, Daddy? Yes, I would like some ice cream. Daddy, you have ice cream on your nose. Daddy? Dad? Oh, it was just a dream. Just a dream. What's wrong with me? He's dead. He's been dead for 20 years now. It's almost funny how there are some things that you can never forget. They are constantly on the front of your brain, driving you insane. I have a family now, 2 kids to look after, a loving husband who treats me like a queen. Yet every day I remember. I know that memory affects the way that I act. Sometimes when I get emotional, I take it out on the kids, but I don't mean to. It's just so hard to keep my anger inside. It's too hard. God, this is so unfair. Why did he have to die and the other guy didn't? The other guy was the one who was drinking. The other guy was the one who was stupid enough to get behind a wheel. The other guy was the one who went through a red light faster than the speed of light. And it is my innocent dad who pays the price for some guy's mistake. Why, I ask you, why? He walked away from the accident. Later, he said to my family that he wished that there was something that he could do. My father is dead because of him. He is dead, and he is not coming back. That's right, dead, and there is nothing that anyone can do. The reason why my dad was out there that night was because I wanted some ice cream. There was none in the house, so he went out to the corner store. We knew something was wrong when he didn't come back quickly. Then there was the phone call. I felt like it was my fault. Everyone says that it's not, but you know, it really is. I was the one who begged him to go out that night. If it wasn't for me and my urge for chocolate ice cream, he would be alive today. He would have seen my graduation, walked me down the aisle, and talked to his first grandchild. But no, he missed out on all of that because some idiot forgot to listen to the don't drink and drive messages. Why couldn't someone grab his keys before he got in the car? The police said that he was at a huge college party. Only one simple gesture. I don't need ice cream anymore.
Mom, can I come in? I just had a nightmare. I dreamed there was a monster with big, pointy teeth chasing me, and it could run at super fast speeds. And it came up to me and tried to eat my head off. I'm scared. Can I come sleep in your bed? I think the monster might come and get me if I go back in my room. It can climb the tree and can get in my window. Please, I promise I won't turn in my sleep this time. You won't even know I'm there. Just please don't let me go back in my room tonight. Thank you. Thank you. You're the best mom ever.
Don't stand too... Is it on? Okay. Don't stand too close to me. Don't look at me. Pretend you're by yourself. I just don't want anyone to think I'm with you. I don't know which Hello Kitty pencil is better. It's just some stupid cat without a mouth. Come to think of it, that's really creepy. Besides, I don't like pink or purple. Are you done yet? I can't believe Mom and Dad made me hang out with you just because we're related. Isn't that their job anyway? Listen, do you have any money? No? Then why are you taking half an hour to decide which pencil is better if you can't even buy one? Come on, let's get out of here. Aw, okay, I'll hold your hand. Let's just go already.
Excuse me? Can I help you? What exactly are you looking for? I can't believe you're in here. You're searching my room? Look it, I know this is your house. You're constantly reminding me that this is your house, but this is my room. Aren't I entitled to some privacy? I might as well be in jail. Random searches, no trust. If you want to know if I'm using drugs, why don't you just ask me? Not that I would tell you, and I definitely wouldn't tell you now. Why would you even think to come in here in the first place? What makes you think I'm using them anyway? Yeah, I heard Miss Nelson found pot in Amy's room. I also heard she got hysterical and threatened to kick Amy out of the house. That's really rational. So just because Amy smokes pot, you think that's a good enough excuse to invade my privacy? Amy and I aren't even friends anymore. I never see her. I don't hang out with her. Why didn't you just ask me? So what's next, Mom? Are you gonna install cameras? Watch my every move? Do you want me to pee in a cup? Would that make you happy?
Dad, stop it. Just calm down, all right? Take it easy. No, no, I won't. Stay away from Mom. Do you hear me? I have had it. You want to go drink yourself to oblivion every night? That's your business. But beating on Mom and slapping me around is over. You got that? Look at you. You think you're strong? Does terrorizing your family make you feel powerful? Huh? Do you know the principal asked the guys at school who the number one idol was? And 90% of them said their fathers. And all I could think was, I idolize anyone who is nothing at all, like my father. Do you realize what an awful feeling that is? As your son, to be ashamed and embarrassed of you? I said, stay back, and I mean it. If you ever take one step closer to me and Mom, I swear to God, I have you thrown in jail for good. You're not the man of this house anymore. Not that you ever were. So either go back to your room and sleep it off, or I'll call the cops. You choose.
Mom, it's not like I fall asleep on purpose. It's just that I have to wake up at 6 a.m., then you expect me to go to math class, and I mean, there's no way I can get up at 6 in the morning and go to math class and stay awake. I just don't get enough sleep. Plus, it's so boring. I mean, my teacher has us sit down, and she starts lecturing us about, I don't even know, stupid math problems. And it's so pointless, and she stands at the board for like 2 hours. Well, it feels like 2 hours. And all she does is write on the board and expects us to copy it down. And so while I'm supposed to be copying it down, I get really tired and I start falling asleep. Then I wake up and I find my paper, and all I can read is a whole bunch of scribbles. So then I start writing down again, and then like 5 minutes later, I start falling asleep again. And so today my teacher caught me and she screams at me. She's like, "Ryan, get up." And I'm like, "Oh, okay." And so I wake up and I start writing again, but it's really just scribbles because I can't stay awake. And this just happens like every day to me. So that's why she finally sent this note home to you, Mom. She's telling you to make sure I get enough sleep. But I think I should just be allowed to skip math altogether.
If you would just listen to me, I'll explain everything. I did not cheat on that test. Why don't you believe me? I'm your daughter. You're going to take some stranger's words over mine? Miss Lander said what? That you found a cheat chart? That's impossible, Dad. I swear I'm not lying. I never made a cheat chart in my life. I couldn't possibly write that small. And I studied. I know the material. Ask me anything. Go ahead, ask me anything about the Lincoln administration or Reconstruction or anything on American history for that matter. I studied. Think I'm being framed. I think the cheat chart was planted. I'd be willing to take the test over, Dad, to prove I didn't cheat. Could you ask Miss Landers if I could take the test again? Honestly, Dad, I want you to be proud of me. You've got to believe me. I'm not a cheater. I guess I get teased sometimes from some of the kids because they always know the answers and stuff. Maybe they wanted to get back at me for being a know-it-all. I don't know why anyone would do this, but don't you think you know me well enough to know I didn't cheat on a test? Have a little faith in your own kid, Dad, please.
No. No, I don't want to. I'm watching TV right now. Why should I? It's a waste of time, and I want to see the end of the show. Sharon's totally overrated, Mom. I'm not dirty. I do not smell. Maybe you smell, Mom. Okay, sorry. But I really want to see this, Mom. Can't you see I'm busy? Will you quit nagging me already? Honestly, Mom, I don't get it. Do you see any dirt? I'm a clean guy. I changed my shirt when I got home from school and everything. Oh, please. Please don't talk to me about my hormones and growing up, Mom. It's gross. Let's just stop talking about it, okay? Don't call me a little man. You can't make me do this. You're not going to win this with Mom. I'm not going to crack, ever.
I will not stay home and babysit my stupid sister. I'm going to the party. And so, you can't make me do anything. Disruptive? I'll show you disruptive. And what are you gonna do if I don't? She's quit even trying. It's like there's nothing I do that will get her to pay attention. I don't want to go to that dumb party. I want, just for once, Mom, I want you to say no.
See it. The plate's clear.
Well, why couldn't you just give it to me?
I didn't want the kids to see. Oh, this is awful. It's Christmas Eve and we have no presents for the kids. What do you think is going to happen when the kids wake up in the morning and find no presents under that Christmas tree?
Honey, I'm sorry.
It's not your fault. How could you be so stupid?
Guys, we're gonna have a 10-minute intermission. Thank you.
I know it's your house, but I don't care. It's my room, so get out. Why are you always checking up on my grades? I'm fine. Everything's under control. So what if I got one C? It's only one C, and the rest of my report card was good, right? So even though all my other grades were A's, it doesn't matter. All because of one C? That doesn't make sense. What do you mean with this attitude I can forget about college? You don't know anything about college. I'll be fine with my own advice. You think this is about being lazy, don't you? Well, I'm not lazy. You just think I'm some slacker who doesn't care about college at all. But you're just twisting the truth because I'm not interested in the pressure yourself to death approach to getting in. By the way, if I am lazy, it's your fault. Yeah, you heard me. I read somewhere that laziness must be genetic. I can talk to you however I want. I'm not a kid anymore. The difference between being a teenager and a kid is simple. Teenagers know when their parents are wrong. Come on, please don't ground me. I'm sorry. You're not changing your mind? Fine, but you still can't make me listen to you anymore.
Everyone shut up. I said shut up. Okay, that's better. I can't believe you people. You are supposed to be my parents. Responsible, hardworking, loving. But all you ever do is fight. And not even about important stuff, but you fight about stupid stuff. Look, I'm tired of being in the middle of your arguments. Look, you want a divorce? Fine, get one. See if I care. But don't expect me to live with either one of you. I'm going to my grandparents' house.
My dad is somewhere overseas, in the Marines. I don't know where, and he's not allowed to tell us, and I miss him. We used to have a lot of fun together. We write him letters now. Sometimes we even get some back, but it takes a long time. I just wish he was back here. I wish I knew how long he'd be away. Now it's just me and Mom and David. I'm the man of the house, and I've never thrown out the garbage so much in my life. And I know Mom is worried, but she pretends not to be. David doesn't know what's going on. He still asks for my dad sometimes, and he's little. I wish I knew what to do to help. I'd throw out the garbage every day for the rest of my time, if that would help. And I heard Mom crying last night. I guess I'm not a very good man of the house. I'll have to try harder until Dad comes home.
Hi, Mom. It's me. I brought some flowers, yellow roses. I know they're your favorites. Look, I know you probably can't hear me, but the doctors say the chemo's in, but it'll take some time to work. They don't know if you'll get better or not. They said you might only have a month to live. Mom, I'm really scared, and I don't want you to die. I need you so much. I know that we fight a lot, and we don't always get along, but I really love you, Mom, and I don't know what I would do without you. I can't take care of Dad and Greg in that house and Spot all by myself. There are so many things you haven't seen me do. I haven't gotten married or graduated from high school or even gone to prom yet. Mom, you won't even get to meet my children. They'll never know what an amazing grandma they had. I need you too much right now. You just can't leave me here alone. I'm so scared. You can't die, Mom. You just can't. You need to get better. You need to be strong and fight. Think of me and Greg and Dad. We all love you. We need you so much. Please fight, Mom. Be strong, because we don't know what we'd do without you. The doctor's calling me. I have to leave now. You're going to get better, Mom, okay? I love you.
Selfish? I'm selfish? How can you say that? Just because I want to go out with my friends instead of sitting around your apartment feeling sorry for you? You always do that. Anytime I want to go out, you tell me how mean and selfish I am, how I don't care about the family. But you're the one who cheated on Mom. You're the one who ripped our family apart. But you can't bear to face that. So instead, you put all your guilt and shame on me. God, is it any wonder that I hate coming here on weekends? And it's not because I don't care about the family. It's because you make me feel so mean and bad that I want to get away. Can't you once stop thinking about yourself and realize that the things you say about me, Dad, make me feel like I'm the most horrible person who ever lived? Why do you do that? Why do you hate me so much?
I love being a little sister. Boo! Annoying, isn't it? I do it to my brother all the time. He gets real mad and tries to hit me. But I yell, "Mom, because he's just trying to hit me," and that makes him stop real quick. Isn't that great? I do lots of mean things to my brother. When his girlfriend calls, I tell her, "Hey, sis is not here. He had a big date tonight." And then when his friends at our boys call, I say, "Sorry, he can't come to the phone. He's on a date with your girlfriend." So I've got my brother beaten up 3 times. I love being a little sister.
Mom, Dad, we need to talk. You always said that I could come to you guys whenever, for whatever, and I got into some trouble. Mom, remember when I was little, you always said you loved me no matter what? No matter what I did or said, you always loved me, right? And Dad, remember? You said that too, and you said that I'd always be your little girl, your baby girl. What I'm trying to say is, well, I mean, Mom, Dad, I'm pregnant. Dad, Daddy, please don't yell at me. I'm so sorry. I'm so, so sorry. I didn't mean for this to happen. I didn't want for this to happen. Nate and I were safe and everything. We were. We really were. Every time. Mom, Mommy, look at me. Please look at me. Please tell me that you don't hate me. Wait, I'm sorry. Yes, Mom, I know. I know what this means. No, he's not gonna leave. Nate's telling his parents right now, too. I know everything's gonna change, even though I don't want it to. And everything's gonna get hard. But Mom, I can't change it now. I made a mistake, a terrible mistake that's gonna affect me, us, for the rest of our lives. And I know I have to realize that. Dad, please don't cry. I've never seen you cry before. I'm so scared. I really am. I never, ever expected this to happen. I mean, I knew it could. I just didn't think it would happen to me. Mom, Daddy, you still love me, right?
Hi, Mom. How's work? Do you think we're gonna stick around this time? I sure hope so. I feel like I'm starting to like this school. Hey, I made you some supper. Would you like something to drink with it? Great. Hey, Mom. You know, since we've been moving around, I really hadn't had a chance to make any friends. And I was wondering if I could borrow $20 this Saturday to take out this girl I met a couple days ago at school. I haven't really asked her out yet, but she seems pretty nice. She actually took the time to get to know me. I figured maybe you could spare a little since we don't go out all the time. Why not? Well, how about 10? Not even $10. It's not like I ask you for money every day. I don't get it. What have I done? Have I done something wrong? Have I disappointed you in some way? I mean, it's not like I sit around on my ass all day watching television or dish my chores. I go to school every day, maintain a 3.2 grade point average while moving all over the damn state. And after school, I go to work and washing dishes 5 nights a week at that greasy restaurant. I never complain and I never get paid. And you know why? Tell me, Mom. Why don't I have any money? Because I give it all to you. I don't see a red cent. And to tell you the truth, I don't think I've ever remembered cashing one of my own checks. They go straight from my hands to yours. I never get a red cent. You hear me? Just give me 2 more years, and when I graduate, I'm out of here. Gone for good. Not coming back. Do you get it? I want to cash my own checks. When I'm hungry, I want to buy myself a hamburger. Now if I see a girl I like, I want to be able to take her out. I think I deserve that. I think I deserve to enjoy life like everyone else. I hate you, and I'm tired of helping you live out your pathetic life. What? Well, say something. Mom. Mom. Mom, I'm sorry. Did you hear what I just said? I'm sorry. Please, just don't cry. I can't take it. Mom, you know I would never really leave you by yourself. I got a little angry. I'm sorry. Hey, why don't we go to the store and rent a movie instead? I'll pop up some popcorn. Wouldn't that be fun? We could rent one of those old comedies that you like. I love you, Mom. I'm sorry.
I ate them. That's right. I ate the divorce papers, Charles. I ate them with ketchup, and they were good. You probably want me to get serious about our divorce. The thing is, you always called our marriage a joke. So let's use logic here. If A, we never had a serious marriage, then B, we can't have a serious divorce. No, we can't. The whole thing's a farce, Charles. A farce that tastes good with ketchup. I mean, wasn't it last week your dad asked you the reason you walked down that aisle with me? And you said, for the exercise. That's funny. You're a funny guy, Charles. I'm laughing, not crying. I'm laughing because you're about to give up on a woman who is infinitely lovable. For instance, Paul, he has known me since the 8th grade. Sure, he's a little creepy, but he really loves me. He's made 127 passes at me, proposed 47 times, and sent me over 200 original love sonnets. He sees something in me, Charles, and he writes it down in metered verse. And that's not something you just find every day. Someone who really loves everything about who you are as a person. Paul may be insane, but I value his feelings for me. I would never ask him to sign his name to a piece of paper promising to just turn off his feelings for me forever. But that's what you're asking me to do for you. To sign away my right to that sweet voice, Charles. Those baby brown eyes. The way your hands feel through my hair before bed. Those aren't things I want to lose. In fact, I won't lose them. I won't lose you. I'll woo you. I've written you a sonnet. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May. And I'm not crying. I'm laughing. It's all a big joke. It's very funny, Charles. I keep waiting for you to say, April Fools, and I'll rush into your arms. But you're not going to, are you?
No.
Of course not. It's not April. I didn't really write that sonnet, you know. Paul did. I think it's good. You see, the truth is, Charles, I ate the divorce papers. I ate them because I can't stomach the thought of losing you.
I'm just a kid, and I don't know what I'm doing sometimes. But I think you should know better when you're all grown up. I think you should know how to act and how to treat people. And I think if you once loved someone enough to marry them, you should at least be nice to them, even if you don't love them anymore. And I think if you have a child, you should treat that child like a human being and not like a pet. Not like you treat your dog or something. You know, when you have a dog, sometimes you forget he's there. And then when you get lonely, suddenly you remember him. And you remember how cute he is and stuff. And you kiss him a lot, but then the next day when you're busy again, you don't notice him. That's how I've been treated for the past 4 years, and you don't treat your kid like your dog. It's not right.
Ah, yes, my parents. They're supremely stupid. You wouldn't even believe it. Full of crap. My dad thinks he's always right, and my mom, well, she thinks she's always right too. But the truth is that I'm always right, and they're too dumb to know it. It drives me crazy sometimes. They never let me do anything because they think I'm gonna act like a dumb kid. I practically came out of the room at 25. I'm definitely the most mature person in my family. Why do you have that weird look on your face? Does it shock you that I talk to my parents like that? It's the truth. They're clueless. They think I'm just some sweet, dumb kid. It's almost laughable. What is it? You look so... Someone's behind me? Who is, Dad, how are you today? How was your day at work?
Sorry just to show up like this. How are you eating dinner? Oh, good. Well, I was just wondering if I could stay here tonight. We got that algebra test tomorrow, and I can't study at my house. My parents are going at it again. It doesn't stop. Just when I think it's over, they start screaming at each other again. My mother's voice is so high-pitched and hysterical. I'm surprised the neighbors haven't called the cops. Sounds like she's being murdered or something. I hate to bother you, Jen. I really do. But if I sit there for one more minute, I will have lost my mind. She's calling him an a-hole, and he's calling her a witch. Why don't they just get a divorce and get it over with? What are they staying together for? The kids? They don't know how miserable they're making me and my brother. He just gets stoned all the time, so he doesn't have to deal with them. They don't even know their own son is a major stoner, and their daughter is on the verge of a nervous breakdown. We would all be so much better off if they just split. Are you sure it's okay? Your mom won't mind. Oh, thanks, Jen. Thanks so much. You're a lifesaver. I'll totally help you study for that test, too. Jen, one more thing. Do you suppose you could ask your mom if it's okay if I stay here a while? A couple of days? A week? Maybe I could just move in with you. I never want to go back to my house again, not with them there.
My stepdad thinks I hate him. No, that's not right. Not exactly. He just thinks I don't love him. And that's not right either. It's just that I still love my dad, even though he did some pretty bad things to mom maybe a few years ago. And it's my stepdad that works and supports our family. I'm grateful for that. And he's a really good guy, but just because mom won't forgive him, forgive dad, it's like I'm supposed to not forgive him too. I wish I didn't have to prove who I love by choosing somebody to hate.
I failed my history exam, okay? Are you happy? Now you can tease me as usual and run off to mom and dad to brag again. It won't be anything new to them. All I ever hear is, Paul got straight A's. Paul made the honor society. Paul got a scholarship. Why can't you be like him? Well, I can't. I study and study, and I try so hard. But I'm not as smart as you. I never will be. Why do you have to rub it in? Don't you realize I spent my whole life trying to be as good as you and trying to keep up? I'm so jealous of you. I can't stand it. And all I ever do is disappoint mom and dad all the time. I'm the stupid daughter, the screw up, and you're the perfect one. I was so bad. They'd once, just be proud of me. And that somehow, in some way, they would love me as much as they love you.
There's a lot of things I didn't understand. A lot of things I'd do different if I could. Just like I think there's a lot of things you wish you could change. But we can't. Some things, once they're done, can't be undone. My wife, my ex-wife, says that she loves Billy. And I believe she does. But I don't think that's the issue here. If I understand it correctly, what means the most here, it's what's best for our son, what's best for Billy. My wife used to always say to me, why can't a woman have the same ambitions as a man? I think you're right. Maybe I've learned that much, but by the same token, I'd like to know what law it is that says that a woman is a better parent simply by the virtue of her sex. You know, I've had a lot of time to think about what it is that makes somebody a good parent. You know, it has to do with constancy, it has to do with listening to him, it has to do with patience, it has to do with pretending to listen to him when you can't even listen anymore. It has to do with love. Like she was saying. And I don't know where it is written, it says that a woman has a corner on that market, that a man has any less of these emotions than a woman does. Billy has a home with me. I made it the best I could. It's not perfect. I'm not a perfect parent. Sometimes I don't have enough patience because I forget that he's a little kid, but I'm there. We get up in the morning and then we eat breakfast and he talks to me and then we go to school and at night we have dinner together and we talk then. I read to him and we built a life together and we love each other. If you destroy that, it may be irreparable. Joanna, don't do that. Please. Don't do it twice to him.
A cell phone? You are in the fourth grade. I don't care if Jenny has a cell phone. Her parents are rich and yours aren't. What do I look like, Donald Trump? We didn't get a small loan of $1 million. And you just cost me money when we went to Mandy's. You needed clothes and that is more important than talking on the phone all day. What do you need a cell phone for anyway? You are in school all day and then you come home. You can talk for free from home. Money doesn't grow on trees. Don't ask me again because the answer is no. You are not ready to have bills and besides, who do you think will be paying for it? What? Family plan? What family plan? No, no. Stop asking. The answer is no. If you are old enough for a cell phone and want to talk all day like you're some kind of Paris Hilton, then you are old enough to get a job. Get a job and then you can get a phone. Don't ask me again.
I don't like the way he bullies you, Mom. What's he gotta push you around like that for? I saw him, Mom. I heard him push you and I heard you scream at him. You didn't think I was home. I was home. I don't like him. He's no good for you or this family. Send him back wherever he came from. He's a total shitbag and I can't stand him. He's abusive. He's changing you, Mom. He's pulling us apart from one another. Don't you see any of this? Jesus Christ, I'm trying to tell you something. Can't you pay attention to me, Mom? Please, I'm your son. Listen to what I'm saying to you. Look at me, Mom. Mom, please, just... son of a... You see? You see what I'm talking about? There's no communication anymore, and nobody knows how to talk to anybody. It's always shouting and violence. It was never like that when Pop was around. I know he isn't great, but at least he didn't beat me. Mom, please, I love you. Can't we just go? Let's just get out of here, you know? Damn this guy. I'm sorry for cursing, but damn this guy, Ma. Look at me. It's been you and me since forever. We don't need anybody but each other. Do you hear me? I love you, Mom. Please, I love you. I'll take care of you. I'll quit school. I'll get a job. I'll help you pay the bills. Come on, it's not too late. We can start again. This time we'll make better choices, Mom. Are you with me? Yeah? You hear me? We can just grab what we need and leave. We can start a new life, Mom. Just you and me like the old day, right? Just us. We can do this, Mom. Come on, I need you to be strong. Haven't you always taught me to be strong? Yeah? Okay. Well, I can't be strong without you, all right? I need you and you need me. I swear I'll never let anybody else hurt you. You hear me? We can do this, Mom, together. Listen, he goes to play golf this Saturday. Damn him. Okay, sorry with the crickets. We'll take off then. I have about $1,000 saved up in cash from all the lawns I've been mowing this summer. And plus, I know you have $2,000 because of what you told me last week. So there, that's $3,000 and a new life, right? I'll plan the whole thing out. Okay, Miami. I heard a lot of good things about Miami lately. What do you think? Interested in some fun in the sun? Okay, then that's what we'll go for. I love you, Mom. You're my life and I die for you.
Hi, I'm sorry to bother you so late, but I was wondering if I could sleep over. Nothing happened, I just tripped. Talk about stupid, but I'm fine, really. I just don't feel like staying at my house tonight. Because it's boring, you know? I thought it would be fun to stay at your place on a school night. What do you say? No, don't ask your mom. She'll call my parents. My dad said I can come. He doesn't care. He doesn't care at all. He's drunk and he slapped me and shoved me against the wall real hard. He hit my mom too. Don't make me go back there. I'm too scared. I'll be real quiet. I promise. I won't make a sound.
I was only 12 when my mother died. It's still hard to think about it, even 2 years later. I mean, she was only 35. How can some stupid disease take someone so strong? I never even got to say goodbye. I never even really said that I loved her. I would give anything, anything for her to be alive still. She was so many things to me. I mean, I really have trouble talking to Dad about girl stuff. He's a guy. He tries to understand me, but we're just not that close. And with Mom dying, I lost a lot of myself along with her. They say it takes a year for a person to get over the death of a loved one. I still haven't gotten over it. I can't talk about her without a sad tone in my voice. I can't reminisce about her smiling without bursting into tears. I know she wouldn't want this. I know she would want me to always love her but lose a horrible pain. It's hard. Mom, do you hear this? Do you look down on me from heaven? I wish you could answer me. I know you can't, but I want you to listen. I want to be happy more than anything. I want to stop the pain. Help me remember only the good times we had and not this horrible loss that I feel. Make it so I don't cry myself to sleep wishing you were there. Be in my dreams if you can't be in my reality. I miss you, but I guess the only thing I can say that will matter is the thing I wish I would have said to you all this time. I love you, Mom.
My mom's ambition in life is to embarrass me. I'm not kidding. She told me that. Yesterday, she came to school in a clown costume and invited people to my birthday party. Last week, she took my picture, you know, the one where I'm naked, and had t-shirts made and gave them all to the cheerleaders. And today, look at her. She's just a good frog. And she's dancing in front of the science lab to protest frog dissections. Okay, Mom, you win. I'll make my bed. I'll wash the dishes. I'll even put the toilet seat down. Anything, just please. Go home.
Look, Dad, I don't know how to tell you this, so I'm just gonna say it. I think it's great that you're coaching the basketball team. I think you'll be a great coach, but I don't want to be on the team. No, it has nothing to do with you. See, that's what I'm talking about. You want me on the team. You want me to be a great basketball player, but you never ask me what I want. I don't even like basketball. I'm not good at it, and I probably never will be. You've never asked me what I want I'm good at. Just because you're good at sports doesn't mean I am. And what I really want to do is study music. That's what I'm good at. Dad, and that's what I want to do. I want to play piano, classical, or jazz. Any kind of music, really. I just want to get really, really good at it. I want to be the best piano player there ever was. And I want to compose my own stuff and play concerts and everything. Come on, Dad, don't be mad. You wouldn't be proud of a son who was lousy on the court, but think how proud you'll be when you see me playing at Carnegie Hall.
Mr. Beckham called you? God, he's so over the top. I admit, I was talking in his class, but the real reason he got so mad was because he thought I was talking about him. And I wasn't. He's way too paranoid. So he gave me detention. It was no big deal. Grounded? What are you talking about? You can't ground me. You're not my mother. You know, you have some nerve.
You just waltz into the picture and screw with my dad's head until he's so confused and blind that he actually marries you. Oh, I mean after you threatened him with ultimatum. Bull, you did too. He even told me he didn't really want to marry you, but he was scared of being alone. I told him to get a dog, but no, he didn't listen. So now he's stuck with you. And hey, that was his choice, but not mine. I have a mom. She's dead, but she's still my mom. And nobody will ever take her place. Not you, not anyone.
That's what this is all about, right, kids? Fun. Fun, fun, fun. Now, let's go try to climb that mountain and we can stop all the bickering and fighting and insanity that seems to exist in our family, and let's try to exhaust the demon out of your little souls so mommy doesn't smack your unconscious. Okay? Are you with me, kids? Fun, fun, fun. Nothing's wrong with mommy. Go ahead, little Bobby. Pick up that giant bug-infested stick and bash it across your sister's jaw. And Sissy, you can pick up that giant boulder and throw it at your brother. Go ahead, since you hate one another so much. Fun, fun, fun. And then we will all reach the top of the mountain. Mommy's going to jump right the hell off so I don't have to deal with this bullcrap in my life any longer. What's that, little Bobby? Oh, mommy said a bad word? Believe me, I want to say worse. I know, son, I know. It is what happens when a mother has been brought to the point of no return, my angel of a son. Mommy this and mommy that. I'm going to change my name. You two kidding one another and I'm playing referee all the time? Fun, no more. No more, my wonderful children. Mommy's going wee right off the mountain. That's it, gone. No more mommy, no mommy to torture. So it is fantastic that we live by the mountains, isn't it, kiddies? Fun. What? Oh, you're going to be good? Yeah? Mm-hmm. I don't know about that. What? Oh, you promise? You promise, mommy? Are you both going to stop fighting? I've had it. Next time, I'm walking out of the door and I'm disappearing for good. Now, you get your asses upstairs. You're both punished and I don't want to hear another sound. That's it. Upstairs now.
Mom, where are you going? What do you mean you don't know? Just leaving? Where's Dad? He's not coming, so you're leaving him? We're leaving him. What if I don't want to leave him? I can too stay with him. He loves me and I love him. I don't mind that he drinks. I'll make him stop. He can stop. We just have to give him time. Please, Mom, don't do this. I know it gets bad and it's scary. I know I said that I hate him too, but I don't. I didn't. I was just embarrassed. He loves us and he's all we have. You don't have a job. We can't do this alone. I don't want to go to a new school. Can't you think this over again, please? Mom, you only think of yourself. This is my life too.
Why should I introduce him to you, Mom? So you can rip him to shreds the second he walks in the door? You've never once approved of anyone I've dated. What is it, Mom? They're too good for me? I'm too good for them? Or is it that you hate all men since Daddy left you? That's it, isn't it? You can't stand to see me happy with someone because you're alone. Well, you can't blame Dad for that one. You pushed him away every chance you got, with your parties and your drinking and yelling all the time. I wanted to run away too, and now he's gone. Not just from you, but from me, Mom. And I'll never forgive you for that. I want my dad back, and it's too late. So don't even think for 1 minute that I'm going to let you drive my boyfriend away too. You chose to be alone. I didn't.
I know you had dreams, Dad. Once upon a time, back in the day, Grandma said you were pretty heavy into your training for a long time, and things looked good for a while. But I'm not you, and I have different dreams. Dreams I'm just starting to know about, just starting to even realize exist. My dreams are just as important to me as yours were to you. And maybe I'll make them come true. Maybe not. But I have to try, the same way you tried. I just wish you could support me and my dreams instead of always making me feel bad because I'm not living up to yours.
Tell me, Brandon, was I actually supposed to believe you? At first I thought maybe I could, but what did I know about you besides what others told me? They said that you were a jerk and that you didn't care about anyone but yourself. But as usual, I didn't listen to what they said. You know, people say love is blind, and I guess that they're right, because I never saw this coming. When you told me how beautiful I was, I actually believed you for a moment. But you want to know the part that hurt the most? It was when you told me that you wouldn't forget me, and that I should never forget you. Well, that's the problem, Brandon. I haven't forgotten you. I called you last night. Someone answered the phone and said you were with some girl. That hurt. I've only been gone 2 days, Brandon, and already you've forgotten your promise to me? I figured you would, eventually, as time went on. But 2 days? I know I've known you for a short time, but when two people's souls connect, what can time say? Nothing. That's what it can say, because pain says it all.
He says he's bound to win, but Ma says he ain't going anywhere. Sometimes I think it's true, and Ma's right. He just ain't. There are two kinds of people in this world. There's people who do stuff, make decisions, get jobs, go to college, eat expensive dinners, have coffee in little cafes with their pretty friends and nice expensive sweaters. And then there's the rest of us. The rest of us who eat microwave dinners and watch TV and don't really do nothing new, exciting, or fresh. The rest of us who don't never even leave where we came from, not because we don't want to, but just because we never get the chance, because we're just not the type of people who got somewhere to go. The way Ma says it is, I think we're just that. The rest, the people who don't really do nothing. You think he's going anywhere? You can hope and pray and dream all you want, but you think he's really gonna win that stupid race and get some stupid prize money and get out of here? If you think that, you got another thing coming. You got disappointment coming, that's what. He's a rested wheel, and rested wheels don't go no place unless you push him hard enough. Unless you really, really push him.
I farted in yoga class. It was loud, and I didn't die. My heart started pounding, but it didn't explode. I thought it would be devastated, but I wasn't. Instead, something unexpected happened. I laughed. At first, a little giggle, and then a full-blown belly laugh. In fact, I laughed so hard that I farted again, and again, and again. Embarrassing, no? No, no. I could feel people staring, but I didn't care. I thought I would care. Feel my palms grow clammy, my chest tighten? No. I felt a lightness, wonder, awe. Who knew I had so much air inside me? My body had deflated, but my spirit had inflated. I waited for the self-loathing to come, but there was only stillness, silence. Then, in that silence, a little voice. I love you. Your body is amazing. I realized this is why I've come to yoga in the first place. No, not to fart publicly. To fart publicly and survive it. I know it's unladylike, but in the depth of this indignity, I had found my greatest strength. Here I was, looking my fear in the face. And believe me, I had feared this moment. I had played it out in my mind, but not much happened. Here I was, staring fear in the face and realizing it was a bunch of hot air, and I could release it. I breathed in deep. So deep, another loud exclamation of my newfound freedom erupted from my behind. Excuse me, the woman behind me said, but could you step outside for a moment? Some of us are trying to practice yoga. This should have destroyed me. It should have sent me crying out of the room. But I felt my calm breath and heard myself say, excuse me, but I am practicing my farinasanas, thank you very much. Then, something amazing happened. A little noise erupted from another corner of the room. A few other people giggled, then laughed, and then more noises erupted. And it was beautiful. A symphony of fart nastiness. I was free, they were free. And I realized in that moment, I was free of you too. You can't hurt me anymore.
Don't I have any say in all this? You always tell me what to do, and you never listen to me. And why should I listen to you? Because you just screw everything up. Well, you're getting divorced, aren't you? That is not a sign of being really good at everything, being the smartest people in the world, being understanding and compassionate. Don't laugh at me. What did I say that was funny? You were too smiling. This is not cute. This is not me being your cute kid. You don't know what's best for me, because what's best for me is to have a family. A whole family, where no one fights and you sit down and have dinner together and you ask me how school was. And I say fine, and I mean it. I don't just say it to shut you up. When do I get to have some say in things? Don't say it. Don't say it when you're an adult. That's bull. When I do something bad, you tell me I'm grown up now and have to take responsibility for my actions, blah, blah, blah. But I want to make a decision. It's, you'll do what I tell you to do, and because I said so. Well, maybe it's time I did start acting like an adult, and I'm going to start by telling you to act your age and stop this divorce thing, because I said so.
That's the end of the show.
Wait. I just need the chance. You know, just one chance. We don't ask for much. We work hard and for almost nothing. We risk imprisonment and death by jumping the border to come to this country. We clean toilets. We wash dishes. We do not mind doing what things that a white man would not want to do. We will do whatever it takes to make a life. I miss my family. I have a little girl back home in Mexico. My wife. I miss them very much. I send them money I live enough to pay rent and eat food, and I send every other penny to my family. One day, I dream about having my family live with me in the United States. I want to be like the others, like you, who were able to come here and make a life. All I want, all my people want, is to make a life, a good life worth living. A note to Donald Trump. I'm not a killer, a rapist, a drunk, a drug addict. I just want to make a life worth living. I pray to God that one day we will be given the chance. I pray to God every night. I pray to God because he hears me and he makes me believe. I pray to God.
Now it's over. Thank you. Thank you for coming.